because he is trying to take you out.
Oh, smack bang!
That was beautiful.
You are looking at one of the most skilled Western Muay Thai practitioners on the planet.
I've missed it. The whole atmosphere, the hard training. I'm very excited. This fight that's coming up has given me the most fire that I've had since fighting. So I'm ready now, and I'm ready to rock and roll.
Oh, smack bang! The big kibosh! Beautifully done. Did you feel the release?
I've just matured as a person. I've realized that I am beatable, and I just need to train a lot harder than what I did and just dedicate myself more.
There's so many weapons, so many ways you can win and lose a fight. We study that, we work out what went wrong, and we do it better. And then practice it in training, practice it in sparring, and then recently practice it in his last two fights since Rotang. And to fight so incredibly with great performances, he's definitely on the right path to get that rematch and to get that belt back.
Here comes the general. I came with the right hand. Naito on the back foot now.
With the second Naito fight, I just adapted because I knew what he was going to bring. And I felt like he had a game plan and I was just going to ruin it for him. He just couldn't touch me. I enjoyed that fight a lot. I feel like once I beat Mongol Petch, I'll be ready for Rotang. He hasn't got a championship mindset. I'm going to keep trying and trying until I do eventually get there, and I will. I've been fighting the top Thais. It's not a problem for me. I fought one of the best Thais out there, and that's Sam A. I had one hell of a fight with him.
Jonathan Haggerty jumps in with a flying knee and then lands a beautiful right hand. Put Sam A. Gyeonghajeo down.
What a performance for Jonathan Haggerty.
Jonathan Haggerty putting on the performance of a lifetime against Sam A. Gyeonghajeo.
A big thing was experience. John had only had 15, 16 fights when he fought Rotang. And the experience he gained from them two fights, and then the experience he's gained since that, has just been incredible. And I think Rotang likes you to stand there and trade. In the first fight, he'd done that, but for a very brief part of that fight. And then apart from that brief 15, 20 seconds, I believe John controlled the fight, controlled the bout.
He'll start the theater, and he'll start the heavy silver. These four outsides, oh, Haggerty tags him!
So basically, we need him to do that, and I know he can do it.
It's
the aggressive start from Rotang! The body shot hurts Haggerty!
They're going to try and come for my body due to the fight with Rotang. In my opinion, them targeting my body is just going to leave them wide open. I'm just going to lure them in. They can come in, they can do what they want to do. Everybody's got a game plan until I elbow them.
That's what people are going to think he's weak there. So we are aware of that and we've got ways of dealing with it. And also he's just got stronger in the body.
I have what a lot of Thai boxers don't have, and that's footwork. And that's movement. I feel like I have the best movement in the game. I was confident before, but I'm even more confident now. And a confident fighter is dangerous.
They always train really hard for John because they know how good he is. They know he's good. The Thais know how good John is.
My plan is just to keep going, just to keep taking them out step by step. There's no rush. Eventually, I do want that world title shot, and I will get it.